Graham, and I hope everyone's having a great day, and welcome to this video. Now, as promised, this is the construction of the spectacular audio project that I posted a couple of days ago. Now, the finished project is here on my desk, and you can see we've got a very, very small microphone element here, which is 4mm by 1.7mm, and that's been soldered onto a donor lead, which came from another cheap lavalier microphone. And then the cable is attached to the frame. I've used some heat shrink tube in here to do that, but I've just tried experimenting with some black cotton, and that appears to be successful. We can lace the cotton to hold the cable against the side of the glasses frame. Ideally, I could use fishing line, the very, very fine fishing line, and that would be transparent, and that probably wouldn't show up on any colour of glasses frame. So I'll try and get a hold of some of that fishing line and try it on another pair of glasses. But here you can see the microphone element is being held in place with some clear heat shrink tubing, and then the other cable is fastened to the frame with these clear heat shrink tubing. But here you can see the lacing of the black cotton to hold that tightly against the glasses frame. So it does require some soldering skills, and if you look at the components that you would need, you'd need a donor cable, and this one again is from a cheap lavalier microphone. The microphone element itself, and I'll put links to that in the video description below, you can see we've got some very fine wires to solder onto these wires for the plug. And to insulate it, you would need some small heat shrink tubing and then some larger heat shrink tubing to go over the joint just to stiffen the wire to add some extra mechanical protection. And then some clear heat shrink tubing to attach these to the frame of your glasses. So it's quite an involved project, and I thought maybe that's beyond the capabilities of a lot of you if you're not used to soldering fine components, or if you don't have a soldering iron or the requisite tools to do the project. So I looked around for some different ideas, and it came to me when I was watching another program on TV where the guy was being interviewed and he had his Apple earbuds on. So Apple earbuds in here. The microphone hangs down just below the mouth, so I thought that would be an ideal solution if we could use the microphone from those devices on the cable, so we'd know soldering needed. All you have to do is get rid of the two earpieces and the job would be good. So that's how we're going to progress the job today. And I got these cheap headphones from Amazon. I think they were two for £9 or something of that order, very, very cheap. And we're going to use those as the donor. And you get two pairs, so if you make a mess of the first pair, you've got the second one to use. So essentially, we're going to cut off the earpiece on the right-hand side, and we're going to cut off the earpiece on the left-hand side. Now, the beauty of the wiring that's in these is it's a sort of Litz wire. It's very difficult to tin, so there's likely to be no shorts when you cut the wire. There is a secondary measure we can use, and that's to disassemble this and then just cut the wires off from the solder pads. We could even solder the new donor lead right onto the microphone element here if you're capable of doing that. Otherwise, just leave the lead as it is. Now, this has a TRRS plug, so it will go directly into your lightning adapter if you're using this to record audio on your smartphone, or if you had the USB-C on the Android devices, again, you'd use your adapter to convert that to the particular phone. If you wanted to use this with your camera, then you'd have to use a TRRS to TRS adapter, like the one I've got here. So that would just plug in to your adapter, and that would plug into your phone, or as I would be doing, using the Rode Wireless Go, or as I'm using now, the Sennheiser wireless lavalier system. So this would just plug into your microphone socket, and that would be on your trouser belt at the back, and you've got the spectacular audio project running. So let's start the project, and I'm going to show you, first of all, how you could do it without disassembling the microphone. And what we need to do is just take a very sharp scalpel, and we're going to cut the wire off here at the end of that rubber bush that holds the cable in place. So we're just going to cut that off. Get rid of that, we don't need it. And similarly with the right hand, similar with the left-hand earpiece, we don't need that. Let's just pull that out of its clip. So making sure we're using the left-hand side and not the lead that's going to the microphone. So we need just to cut that one off. And again, cut it right off to the wipey so there's no wire showing. So just a very clean cut. making sure we are on the earpiece. We are. Cut that off just there. Get rid of that, we don't need it. And now we have the microphone ready for us to use. So we could use double-sided tape, and if I bring out a pair of glasses that we could use. So again, these were a purchase on Amazon. These particular glasses are clear glass, so there's no optical prescription. They're intended to use as blue light glasses to reduce the amount of blue light coming from your PC screens to protect your eyes and rest your eyes just before you go to bed, before you retire. So we're going to use these glasses as the frame to mount the microphone. Obviously this is white, so if you wanted to use a felt tip pen and color that black, or spray paint it black if you wanted to really conceal it, then that would be good. But we're actually going to mount that here on the frame and then run the cable down the glasses like that. Could either use that black cotton to attach it, or you could use small pieces of double-sided tape. So that would be your preferred option, just to use double-sided tape and put that in position there and run the wire down the glasses frame, and that would be the job complete. What I want to do is actually take this apart and just get down to the microphone element. So let me just open this up. And these are just normally clipped together using plastic pips. So let me just open this gently. So here we can see the three switches that are normally used for the plus and minus volume control and the skip track, whatever. Those are the two leads that would normally go to your right hand earbud. Turn this over, you can see we've got the microphone element and a little chip here which controls the forward, back, etc. So those are the two wires that are actually going to come in for the microphone. So we can actually solder our donor lead onto those two pads if you have sufficient skills, or we could just leave this as it is. Because I'm going to use this on the frame with just double-sided tape, I'm going to cut these two wires off here again, close to that rubber there, so we don't need these two wires. So again, just going to cleanly cut those off. We don't need them. Again, I'll be using double-sided tape to stick this to the glasses frame, but what I'm going to do is put a piece of clear heat shrink over the microphone so that it gives some mechanical strength to the cable here, and then we'll cut a small hole in it to allow sound to get to the microphone element. So I'll just cut some clear heat shrink tube and I'll join you in a minute. So I've got some clear heat shrink tubing which I've just slid over that printed circuit board. Provide some protection for the back, but there is a piece of plastic there which will insulate it anyway. But I put this over to give me some mechanical strength to the joint as well. The first piece I tried cutting a hole in the sleeving before shrinking it down, but the stresses caused by the shrinking actually tore the plastic. So I'm going to cut the hole after we've done that. So I'm going to use my hot air gun again. You could use your own domestic hairdryer, just throttle back the air so you get a hotter airflow, but ideally a hot air gun is the answer. But let's just shrink that down. So there we have the heat shrink tube now supporting the cable. So let it cool down a second. And then we can see the microphone element there. I'm just going to use a scalpel to cut a small hole in it to allow sound to pass into there. So let it cool down a second. It's still quite warm. That's fine. We'll just trim that end off. And then we'll cut a small hole in the microphone here. So now we've got a clear passage for the audio to reach that microphone element. Now we'd use some double-sided tape so we can actually stick this to the glasses frame. So it would be in sort of that position. So I'll just get some double-sided tape and we'll proceed to fasten this to the legs of the glasses. So now we're going to attach the microphone to the frame of the glasses, and I've got some double-sided adhesive pads here. I've also got some 6mm wide double-sided adhesive tape, so I can actually stick this down the legs of the glasses, or we could use the black cotton to lace it, or we could use the clear heat shrink tube and use that, whichever option you could prefer. So first of all, I'm going to cut a length of this double-sided tape to use to stick this to the frame, so about 4mm wide, probably the whole length of that tape. So we'll cut this 4mm wide. So I'm going to hopefully peel that off. We'll apply that to the back of the microphone. So, and now we can position that onto the spectacles, and we need to place the microphone element as close to the hinge as we can get it. So let's take off the protective tape. And now we'll position it on the glasses frame, just behind the hinge. And parallel to the glasses frame. We can stick that in position. Like so. So now we've got the microphone element securely fastened to the glasses frame. We can now take the cable down the frame and over the earpiece. We could use scotch tape, and I'll do that just for the just for this particular part of the video. I'll try lacing it with cotton later, so we'll just use the adhesive tape something like that, and then a couple of pieces down the earpiece. So, one at the end, perhaps. Obviously, you take your time doing this to make sure you've got a neat finish. So, there we have the microphone attached to the glasses frame, and then you could use some black felt tip pen if you wanted to colour that tape in, or if you used a thinner material it would not show, or if you use that fishing line you could lace the whole thing to the glasses frame. I think that would be probably a much neater solution. So to prove this works, let me just stop the video. I'll attach these to the microphone and you can see the final result. So these are the spectacles that we just added the microphone element from the donor earbud set, just removing the microphone element and then attaching it to the sides of the glasses. The hardest part is actually concealing the microphone in the glasses frame. If you've got a thinner frame, then you're probably better using that very small microphone capsule that I showed you initially, and that's the one that I used on my own glasses here, which is a smaller frame, so that microphone element, the small microphone element, is a lot better to conceal than the element with the printed circuit board. So you can get a much neater finish if you use that smaller one, but obviously you've got to solder the wires onto the donor cable to make it more secure. So I'm going to finish these off a little bit better so we can actually see how they would look if you actually took your time to finish it. And then we'll have a look at that in the video. Well, I actually used the thinner double-sided tape in the end rather than the pads, which are much thicker. So the thinner tape allowed it a much more concealed look. And to fix the wire to the frame of the glasses, I've used just black cotton and just did a lacing or a hitch stitch down there to fasten it to the frame. I do think that the very thin nylon fishing line would be a better solution, as you can tie the knots on each lace all the way down and you get a much more secure finish. Again, you could even use that Scotch tape to fasten it to the frame. Depends what skills you've got and what materials you've got to hand to be able to do that. But there we are, that's the completed project. Hope you found that useful. I'm going to do a complete write-up and I'll put it in the electronics for photographers section of my photographer's blog. So that should be there in a couple of days' time when I've updated the project with the new components if needed. I'm also going to construct one using the microphone element, but I'm going to solder the lead directly to the printed circuit board so I don't have this additional Y piece still left on there. And I've got the TRS connector rather than having to use a TRS to TRS adapter to complete the project. Well, that's it for this quick tutorial on how to make the spectacular audio glasses. If you do like what you see and would like to see more of this, see the subscribe button at the end of the video, click that and the bell notification icon, and then you'll be advised when I upload new videos. So until the next one, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the very, very next one. Goodbye for now.